Hello friends, today we will discuss about the optical return loss in fiber media. So basically, the total of all reflectance and backscatter is called the optical return loss. We will discuss these things in details in the next few slides. So the measure of amount of light that is reflected back from a feature's forward power to the reflected power, that is called the optical return loss. Suppose this is optical media. And there is a discontinuity in the medium, like there is a splicing or there is a connector or there is a laser to fiber interface is there. So this is the incident light and this is the reflected light and this is the transmitted light. So optical return loss can be calculated by this formula: 10 log 10 incident power divided by reflected power. So here you can see that there is a connector in between the two fibers, and this is the incident light, this is the reflection, and this is transmitted light. So incident light divided by reflection light and 10 log 10, and when these PI and PR are in the milliwatt, then we use this formula to calculate the return loss in dB. So in telecommunication, return loss is the loss of power in the signal returned reflected by a discontinuity in the transmission line or optical fiber. So we'll discuss the discontinuity in the transmission line or optical fiber in the next slide. So this discontinuity can be mismatched with the terminating load or with the device inserted in the line. It is usually expressed as a ratio in decibel, where RL is the return loss in dB, PI is the incident power and PR is the reflected power. These two parameters in the milliwatt or watt. Return loss is a measure of how well devices or lines are matched. These are the important norms. A match is good if the return loss is high. A high return loss is desirable and results in a lower insertion loss. So an optical media with a high return loss is desirable. In optics, particularly in a fiber optics, a loss that takes place at discontinuities of refractive indexes. Discontinuities of refractive indexes means if there is a change in the medium. That's why there is a change in the refractive index. So these are the discontinuities, especially at an air glass interface such as a fiber and face. So whenever there is an end of the fiber, it is going to the connector or the receiver or any photodiode. So there is a discontinuity in the fiber and faces, and at that time the ORL comes into the picture. We will discuss in that next slide. At those interfaces, a fraction of the optical signal is reflected back towards the source, and this reflection phenomena is called the Fresnel reflection loss or simply the Fresnel loss. So moving to the next slide. These are the scenarios when reflectance and ORL comes into the picture. Practically, the cases where the light travels from one medium to another with change in the refractive index of medium, in that case, the reflectance and the ORL optical return loss comes into the picture. So here are some scenarios in which the reflectance and the ORL comes into the picture. When the light is emitting from the light source, that is LED or any laser, and goes inside the fiber. In this, the light travels from air interfaces to the glass interfaces. Light travels in medium with different refractive index. So in this case, the ORL and reflectance comes into the picture. Second case, when there is a splicing is done, the refractive index at splicing point is unmatched. There is not ideal matched. Ideal matching is not possible due to index matching gel is used to match the line. Ideal matching is not possible, but to match the index at a very high level, we use the matching gel. So ORL can be improved by using this. So whenever there is a splicing return, there is always a little amount of reflection would be happen. So in that case also the reflectance on ORL comes into picture. When the two fibers are connected via the connector, in this, the light travels from air interface to glass interface, and again light travels from the glass interface to the air interface to the glass interface. Then there is a connector and the light is going from one fiber to the another fiber. So in this case also the reflectance comes into the picture. So there are different types of connector which is good for ORL and good ORL value and less ORL value. So these are the connectors: air gap, flat PC, PC and APC. This is a physical contact, APC is the angle physical contact. So there is a typical reflectance value for the different connectors. So here for the APC, the reflectance is minus 60 dB or higher. Ultra PC minus 40 and 50. Physical context minus 30 to minus 40, and flat air gap is minus 20. So best connector is APC, because for this connector the reflectance value is minus 60 dB or higher. So the ORL value is very good for this APC angle, so the very less amount will be reflected, and hence this connector is best. In the left image, the LED and the single mode fiber is showing. When the light goes from LED into the fiber, the light goes from air into the fiber. There is a different medium light travels, that is different in refractive index, and this is the reason of reflectance. Light reflected back at that point where the medium or the refractive index changes. So these are very important points where the reflectance and ORL comes into the existence. So these are all the points where the ORL value affects the systems. Connector reflectance, this is a practical explanation, like reflectance or optical return loss, which is also called being back reflection of the connector, is the amount of light that is reflected back to the fiber toward the source by light reflections of the interface of the polished end surface and the connector and air. It is called Fresnel reflection. It is caused by the light going through the change in index of refraction at the refractive index of the fiber 1.5 and air is equal to 1. So we have already discussed, whenever there is a change in the medium or whenever there is a change in the refraction index, the ORL, the reflection will be happens, and then optical return loss comes into the picture. Reflectance is primarily a problem with connectors, but may also affect mechanical splices which contain an index matching gel to prevent the reflectance. So in traditionally, we just the connector was main region for the reflectance, but nowadays whenever there is a splicing, there is also a ORL comes into the picture. Reflectance, one component of the connector's loss, representing about 0.3 dB loss for a non-contact or air gap connector where the two fibers do not make contact. Minimizing the reflectance is necessary to get the maximum performance. So reflectance should be low and optical return loss should be high. Actually, these both are the same terms with the negative signs. We will discuss in the next slide. In multimode system, reflections are less of a problem but can add to background noise to the figure. Since there is a more problem with single mode system, manufacturers have concentrated on solving the problem for these single mode components, but multimode connectors benefit also, since any reduction in reflectance also reduces loss. Several schemes have been used to reduce reflectance, mainly using convex physical contact. So we have already discussed some connectors, like APC is most reliable and beneficial in case of this ORL. So these are the techniques, connector techniques, which help to reduce the reflectance and improve the ORLs. So there is a relatively discussion about the reflectance and ORL values. The term reflectance is defined as the ratio of reflected optical power to the incident optical power at the reflecting object. So here we are seeing this is the incident light, and the some amount of light is reflected back whenever there is a discontinuity in the refractive index, and this is the transmitted light. So by these three values we can calculate the optical loss, return loss and reflectance. So this value, incident light, transmitted light and back reflection, is in the milliwatt or watt. So the optical loss can be calculated by this 10 log 10 incident light divided by transmitted light, this incident light divided by transmitted light. So it will give the optical loss, and that results in plus dB. Return loss is equal to 10 log 10 incident light divided by reflected light. So this is incident divided by reflected light, so it gives the value of return loss in plus dB. And reflectance is equal to 10 log 10 reflected light divided by incident light. So this reflected light divided by incident light, and this is just opposite of the return loss, so it gives the value of reflectance in minus sign. So coming to the next, represents the return loss with negative signs indicate the reflectance. So reflectance is equal to the return loss but with the negative sign. The higher the reflectance, the more light reflected back towards the incident light. Minus 50 dB reflectance is better than minus 20 dB reflectance, and 50 dB ORL values greater than 20 dB ORL values. Return loss and reflectance are the same thing, except the sign are different. A positive value is normally used to define the return loss of a connection to matched connector. A negative value is used to define the reflectance of a connection. So this is an important point. A positive value, it defines the return loss of a connection, and the negative value used to define the reflectance of the connection. So OTDR typically use a negative value for connection reflectance. A high return loss is a good thing and usually results in the low insertion loss. Optical loss for connector, sometimes called attenuation, is simply the reduction of optical power induced by transmission through a medium such as a pair of fiber connectors. Return loss is the amount of light reflected from a single discontinuity in an optical fiber link such as a connector pair. Return loss is also called the reflectance. For perfect transmission, optical loss and reflectance power should be zero. But this is the ideal condition. This is not practically possible. Calculation of ORL. So here is a little example how to calculate the reflected back power. So this is the medium, this is the light source, this is the TPT transmitted power, this is the PAPC. PAPC means the reflected power from the APC connector. This is PF, this is the backscattered power of fiber. So there are the different component, there are different component is used. So at different component, different connectors, I mean number of connectors are used. So these are the is fraction of power. This is the PAPC physical contact. This is the PAPC. This is the PAPC reflected power at the reflected power of the connector towards the source side. And this is the backward scattered power of the fibers from the different segment. This is different PF. PAPC is the back reflected power of APC connector, and PPC is equal to the back reflected power of PC connector. So this is the photodiode. So this is the light source, and this is the light receiver. So ORL value is equal to 10 log PT divided by PB. This PB is equal to the total amount of back reflected power. So this is PF calculation, all the PAPC and PPC plus PF. So all the PB, total amount of back reflected power, is PB. So ORL value can be calculated by this. Example, an open connector end face may have a reflectance of minus 14 dB or return loss of plus 40 dB. If there is a lot of reflected power, say a 4% reflectance from an open ended connector, the calculation for reflectance would be 10 log 10.04. And depending on the arrangement of the ratio that produced by the 4% reflectance, the calculated return loss would be plus 14 dB return loss or minus 40 dB reflectance. 4% reflectance means 100 unit of incident power and 4 unit of reflected power. So we have the incident power, we have the reflected power, and we have the transmitted power. So we can calculate the optical return loss, optical loss, and the reflectance by these formulas. So what is the calculation of optical return loss when the P input power and the reference power is in dBm? So optical return loss, this is the input power and this is the reflection power, reflected power. Input power is equal to minus 20 dBm and reflected power is minus 45 dBm. So optical return loss is equal to P in minus P reflection is equal to 25 dB. So we can calculate this directly when it is given in the dBm. This is optical loss. And when this is given in milliwatt, then we can calculate by return loss is equal to 10 log 10 PI divided by PR. So here is a little example of high and low ORL effect. So how the high ORL value and the low ORL value affect the systems. So high ORL value is good for the system, for optical system. But what happens if the ORL value is low? So here is an example of connectivity of amplifier and the WSS. This is an example of automatic power reduction alarm. So suppose this is the system where the ORL value is low. So this is the transmitted power and this is the reflected power. Low ORL means the much amount of transmit power is reflected back towards the source. This is the actual meaning of the optical return loss. So if the ORL value is low, it means the high amount of power is reflected back towards the source. In ORL value, the reflected power is proportional to the transmit power. Means fixed optical medium, the higher the transmit power, the higher will be the reflected power. So if the ORL value is low and the transmit power is much, so the much amount of power will be reflected back. So this is the cause for the automatic power reduction. In picture, when the ORL is low, high amount of TX power is reflected back. Usually amplified TX power is very high, and when the ORL is low, higher amount of power is reflected back toward the TX and it may be damaged. So to avoid this situation, IPR comes into the picture. When there is a reflected power back towards is crossed to a particular set threshold, the amplifier automatically reduces TX power to save the device, to save actually itself. So this is example of this is the effect of low RL values. So thanks for watching.